ending inventory. It is highly likely that a business will not sell the entirety of its inventory at the end of each accounting period, meaning any on-hand unsold stock becomes an asset that must be valued and included in financial statements. This is referred to as ending inventory and is actually quite simple at first glance. Take the beginning inventory, the unit carried over from the end of the previous financial period. Then add any newly purchased inventory throughout the accounting period and subtract any unit sold. And this leaves final inventory figure to be included as a company asset. Therefore, the ending inventory is equal to beginning inventory plus purchases minus sales. However, we need to assign an actual value to the unsold inventory figure, such as how much this company asset is worth in monetary terms. And this is where it can become a lot more complicated. This is because numerous purchases of new stock and raw materials are usually made during a typical 12-month accounting period. Each purchase may have come at a different cost per unit. Sales are also being made at the same time, turning inventory into cash. So, which cost per unit figure do you use to value unsold inventory when there are so many moving parts in a typical accounting period? This is where inventory valuation method plays their role.